Leslie Marmon Silko said, "I will tell you something about stories. They aren't just entertainment. They're all we have to fight off illness and death. You don't have anything if you don't have stories." So today we have 8 beautiful stories. And this is why I love my 13 years here at Center, is I brought stories home with me every day. And this man's story is amazing. Alejandro learned about the center sort of randomly. He lived in California through a friend and called one day and was on his way to Colorado not long after that. But Alejandro's story is much deeper than that. He's overcome tremendous obstacles in his life. His family, before he, as a child, his family was homeless for a time. His father was murdered when he was 5 years old. It was a mentor in Alejandro's life, a woman named Marinella, who held him up and pushed him to move to education. "Get an education, Alejandro, get an education." And she couldn't be here today, but it was very clear to me in talking to Alejandro how important she was to his life. The center is a treasure of stories. This is what makes this space unique and beautiful. My favorite story of Alejandro is in my classroom. I made my students act. Even on this very stage. So my students read a book about a woman in the 19th century who lived south of Denver. She washed people's clothes for a living. She was a single mother. And left a diary for us to learn from her life. And Alejandro played her performance.
That's
that
really far.
An unbelievable performance. It's on tape somewhere. I don't know where it is. I just want to say that Paulo Freire, my inspiration. He taught that every teacher is really a student because they're learning from the students more than the students are from them, and they take those lessons home with them. I learned libraries from Alejandro.